long as I stay right around this area.
Yeah, you're good to go. Well, no, it covers most of the room.
Neat. It's a wide angle.
Yeah. I can zoom it out, so.
Nice.
All right, so you're basically completely cold.
Yes.
Okay. Do you have straws, by chance?
I didn't bring one. Well, I always forget.
That's okay. Well, just borrow one of mine. Well, you can have one of mine.
Yeah, I'm not going to give this back. Sorry.
No. Yeah, how about we do that through the straw? Let's try an eval. Put the rhythm into it now. A instead, maybe?
Yeah, it's kind of getting a little tight as we go higher.
Yeah, how about putting your hand at the end of the straw and just focus on the feeling of flow against your hand? Especially as you rock up for that leap up. Yeah? How you doing?
Something tight here. Just gonna give myself a little massage.
Yeah. Instead of with the straw now, let's try just a hum with your tongue out. Yeah.
My speaking voice even sounds better.
Yeah. I mean, the straw and, you know, the SOBT things are
accessible.
Yeah, are really, really good things to do. Let's do just actually a little bit of humming and chewing. So maybe try that pattern here and just hum and chew. Yeah, and then actual chewing kind of motion. Pattern through on A. pattern again on the off. Stay with the straw and then alternate it with maybe, how about da 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 da. Switch back to the ah and the e, this next one. Does ah feel different after having done the ah?
Mm-hmm.
For the better in your mind?
Yeah, I think before my tongue wasn't as released and the roof of my mouth wasn't as...
lively.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Do the one with the at again. So this will be da da.
Da 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 da.
A little snort and try that again.
Da 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 da.
Okay, and now do the ah e, same spot. Gonna be a little more settled as we head back up.
E again?
Yeah, E. Snort in front of that. Yeah. Tell me about that.
What I've been concentrating on with the E is letting the root of my tongue release.
Uh-huh.
It kind of feels like it lengthens this way.
Uh-huh.
I think the snort kind of lifts the soft palate a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And that makes more room for the tongue to release upward.
Yeah. Sounds counterintuitive.
Mm-hmm.
However, could you try so like the rolled R in German and French, spoken German and French?
Maybe.
Yeah.
That one's
yeah.
Good for me.
Okay, now try. Wait,
have started out a little smoother.
I mean, the whole thing about doing the, you know, just like a snort is a oscillation of your soft palate, is the back of your tongue kind of flopping around.
Mm-hmm. I'm a little flimmy today because the cedar's been bad outside.
Yeah.
But things are loosening up now.
Yeah. Would you, do you want me to close that?
No, I'm good.
Okay. Stay with the straw and let's do this with the straw upwards and then do the with yourself on that first one, and you know, if a straw helps, fine. If a raspberry helps, fine. If a snort helps, fine. If jiggering the vowels around, I mean, you're just trying to get that mid-range feeling spontaneous and the onset easy and things moving fluidly.
Yeah. My middle range has gotten a lot better.
Yeah. Okay.
All that church choir singing.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, for sure. For sure. How about we do a little... Just like... Let's do instead. Just kind of bounce.
Some students, when I try to tell them to do that, they can because they're laughing too hard.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yep.
Hello.
What time did you get up this morning?
Like 9.
Hence the text message.
Yeah.
Running about 10 minutes late.
Oops.
Well, you know.
Yeah.
You're fresh. Let's just, you're
yeah.
fresh. How
and
much,
then,
And
then it took me like 30 minutes to decide what to wear.
Oh, well, of course. How much hydration?
Not enough.
Uh-huh.
I would like some. I'm
Do you
almost
need,
out.
Need more?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, come on up. Watch for the music stand there. Yeah, you may need to move it. Ah, perfect.
Ah.
So I thought, since both pieces, but especially Handel,
mm-hmm.
combine agility with florid, that we might do two exercises back to back.
Okay.
Doing an agility one, take a breath, and do a florid one.
Cool.
Both pieces, you got a lot of triadic figures.
Yeah.
You know, they both really are. I mean, the opening line of both arias, you know, is like, and here, here's an arpeggiated chord. So, I was thinking we do like a and then dreadfully low for you. Let's go up a step.
And what was the second one?
And then
today.
I'm thinking of that line in the Star Trek movie. I'm projecting many attitudes. Which one are you referring to, or something like that? That Spock says. Okay. Give me bored.
Okay.
your best teenage face there. Yeah, okay. How about a little saucy, a little spicy? Singing out a little more would feel good, then go ahead and do so. I don't know, pick your affect. Okay, on this pattern, I got a little of, I'll get you, my little pretty. Was it right?
I don't know. Scorn was what I was going for.
Okay. Yeah, right. Let's,
My whole back is, like, cramping because of reasons.
Yeah. I could grab a chair if it would be better.
No. I'm good. I'm just trying to, like, stretch it out.
Yeah. Okay. Maybe one more. And let's, joyful. When you're lower in your range, your tongue tends to want to sit further back from. When you're up high, I see it, the tip come forward. But I don't see that so much when you're down lower. Could you, I don't know, tha or ya there on the start? So, yeah. So by the time you get to the bottom of that, be thinking, just a little more tongue forward, and then the be thinking that.
Just so flimmy.
Yeah.
It's all shaken loose now, and it's like, you should cough that up now. I'm just thankful I can breathe through my nose today.
Joyful.
But that's not necessarily a bad thing to start out with. If I need more of a forward tongue. Because it's not something that I've been doing, obviously, but if it needs to happen, then it might feel weird at first.
Okay, yeah.
But I didn't feel, like, tight or anything.
Right, just like you were thinking about
it. I was having to think about
it. You're having to think about it. Go down a half a step. No. I think it's just kind of a, yeah, like a get in front of the mirror and kind of go, I'm seeing it on the ah. That's the, that's.
No, my tongue just feels like really big because
I'm
thinking about it.
Yeah, right, exactly.
Brains are very weird.
Yeah. You want to do one more vocalise? You want to get to the piece?
Let's sing.
Okay. Want to do mono first?
Yeah, especially. I'm trying to decide which one. I'm probably going to sing the silver aria first at my audition next week.
Uh-huh.
Just because I feel like it falls out easy.
Well, right. And that's an opera that gets done, and...
Does it get done?
Uh-huh. Baby Doe? Yeah. Yeah, I mean, it's a showcase for a high soprano, plain and simple,
mm-hmm.
you know. Yeah, and it's American, and
mm-hmm.
you got a good C sharp, and you know.
Yeah. But I'm trying to decide if I should tell them I'm going to do Tornami just because it's better known than the other one.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Tornami versus the Platé, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, the Platé is it's a cool piece, you know, because people go, wow, I've not heard that aria either before, or I've only heard it a few times.
Mm-hmm.
That might pique someone's interest, but I think if you're singing in front of opera people and you want to make a good impression and that they can kind of compare,
mm-hmm.
Tornami, I think,
it's better known.
Yeah,
it's
yeah,
performed
it's,
more often because it's in that anthology.
Well, it is, and it's Italian Baroque,
mm-hmm.
which they probably have a greater
yeah.
acquaintance with than
yeah.
French Baroque.
For sure. For sure. That's why the Bach Soloist Academy is asking for an Italian Baroque aria.
Yeah. And besides that, I mean, there are stylistic things
mm-hmm.
that you're doing because that's such an oddball character
mm-hmm.
that this is much more straightforward. It's like, listen to me sing pretty high
yeah, I think
stuff.
I think that's probably the better choice for
yeah.
this particular thing.
Yeah.
So I will send them that email and let them know.
Yeah.
Because I submitted my French
uh-huh.
in the pre-screening.
Uh-huh.
But I got called back, so.
Yeah. So, who's playing? Just like one of their coaches?
I think
or
so.
Houston?
They
or?
Didn't say, but they did say if you needed to change your repertoire to let them know, so.
No, I think Silver and Tornami, I think, is that's a
mm-hmm.
good... That's a good contrast because Silver is
more lyric.
It's lyrical line and a
mm-hmm.
beautiful, delicate, you know, messa di voce up there, and this is vocal display. It just
yeah.
really is.
Wait till you hear my new ornamentation.
Okay.
It's pretty
okay.
dope.
Okay.
Did some research. I listened to several different people, and I thought that my original ornamentation that I wrote in grad school was pretty good. So I kept some stuff from that, and then I borrowed some stuff from other people.
Uh-huh.
It's pretty fun.
Do you want to maybe do the B section, and then go back and do the A with the repeat?
Sounds good.
Yeah. All right. Some of the E vowels up high could use a little more adjustment. They're a little
mm-hmm.
on the close side.
Mm-hmm.
Can we go through that one more time?
Yes.
Come!
Yeah, when you do the... it sounds to me like the L is affecting the del.
So the L's coming in too soon at the end of del?
Yeah. Could I hear right there? Mortis
Arocrona.
Yeah, I'm hearing a little more de. Yeah, so I go ahead and sing da da.
Jeez. It's all shaking loose. Annoying.
Have a good swallow or two. Better on the del. Because if you go my, it's too closed on that second vowel there. Same phrase again, and I thinking about flow, like flow through, like intentionally, like, okay, he can't want it this breathy. It's not going to sound breathy, I promise you, but really thinking a lot of flow.
I'm going to do something that Rochelle gave me to practice it.
Okay.
Okay.
So you're exhaling while, yes. While, okay, yep.
But I think I get the idea.
Right. Yeah, so you're doing the articulation and you're exhaling and wanting the warm air feeling on there. Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. Or even just you can audiate and just exhale through, you know, that idea of, okay, this is the flow I want to rehearse, and then you immediately sing after. Do you want to try the standing wave through there? So yeah, I would. It's so typical Handel, you know, where he starts kind of doing these jagged rhythms.
Yeah.
You know, he does that right at cadences, you know, the jagged rhythms and the syncopations and things like that. I mean, he's kind of doing like a hemiola thing here for a couple of bars. And it's easy to stop the flow, you know, because we're trying to do that rhythmic thing. You want to do the whole section now again?
Sure.
And we'll get to the bells and whistles.
Ja
ti donai miocor.
Ja ti donai miocor. Ja ti donai miocor. Finito sarà il mio amor. Mai tesoro crudel darò.
Watching the front vowels up there. Okay, so now you have some bells and whistles to show me.
Mm-hmm.
New bells and whistles.
New bells and whistles. Some of them are similar, some of them are new.
Alright.
Torna mia vagheggia. So different than yesterday, so my brain's getting confused because I have, been singing this in several different spaces, and so it's like,
sure,
feedback's different.
Yeah, this is different.
Yeah.
Take just a sec and do a little tongue stretch side to side. I mean, you don't have a ton of text to articulate up there, but as we were talking about with the cadential thing, you know, this aria has a rhythmic propulsion to it, and...
Ooh, I lost a little bit of the flow there.
Yeah, making sure that articulation-wise, things are very, very easy throughout. Whenever you're ready. The stuff you were doing at the, the stuff, from there on was just, love it.
Mm-hmm.
Love it, love it. Can I hear the first stuff again?
Mm-hmm.
Just to kind of get it in my head. So the faster you sing, the calmer you have to breathe, right?
Yup.
Easier for me to say sitting over here at the piano, but yep.
Torna mia vagheggia.
Making the fast stuff happen? I mean, is it...
To me, it feels like it's going with the rate of my vibrato.
Uh-huh. Yeah, no, I get that. What I'm getting at is, do you feel like when you're moving fast, what helps you articulate things? Are you feeling like it's a breath thing, or that it's I'm thinking about pitch changes?
I'm not really thinking about pitch changes as much. I kind of, like, the pitch changes are happening, like, with the vibrato wiggles.
Uh-huh.
So I'm kind of thinking of, like, it's flowing, but I do have to, like, speed up my vibrato a little bit to go the speed that I want.
Yeah, right.
I think there's a lot of suspension feeling in my ribs.
Yeah. Yep, yep.
So it's kind of more of a outward motion with my ribs and like an inward motion here.
Yeah, okay.
Something like that. It's hard to describe.
No,
I just
I get that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, the thing I'm getting at is that it doesn't get too respiratory driven, that it's not, you know, you know, that you're kind of pulsing.
Does it seem like I'm pulsing?
Sometimes, yeah, to do the really fast articulations.
Mm.
And so, maybe let's put just flowing gesture with it, and with that idea of, you know, just a little, I want to keep the clarity without having any extra drive. I guess that's what I'm after.
Yeah. Torna mia vagheggiar, tesoro d'amor, Cristo rima fedele, caro mio bene.
That sounds more flowing to me up here.
It felt more flowing too.
Yeah, I really, really, really like that. Well, okay. Let's go on. Yeah, that stretch. Do you want to do any more with terrace dynamics? Because I wasn't really getting a lot of that when you'd have the repeat of the figure.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's a common thing people do in that stretch.
Yeah, I was doing... Last night I did terrace dynamics with staccato on the first A section.
Uh-huh.
We'll see what happens.
Okay, so you just jump. Let's do it. Or whatever you're doing there on the repeat.
Is the object of my affection is here the first time.
Yeah.
They kind of reject me. Mm. And so I'm like, I already got this. Like, I already gave this, my heart to you. Like, what more do you want?
Yeah.
And then in the little interlude, I read into something that they do before they leave.
Uh-huh.
As thinking that maybe they did give in a little bit. So the second half, or the second, the return, the da capo, is like, this is going to happen, and I'm excited and I'm happy about it.
Right.
So they are going to come back.
Yeah. This is like the craziest plot of all time, you know? Because you're Alcina's kind of...
Isn't Morgana Alcina's sister?
Yeah, and cohort, you know. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, the person you're interested in is actually woman disguised as a man.
Mm-hmm. Very queer, I love it.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, anybody who wants to go on a riff, it's like, hello, anybody look at opera? We've been doing gender bending in opera since, like, the beginning of all opera.
Mm-hmm. Not least because, like, women weren't really on stage in Italy until the 19th century.
Or the
17th century,
yeah.
I guess. But
So, naughty things going up, you just don't, I mean, I like them.
Mm-hmm.
I'm wondering if it's a little over the top. It's a little too much. I mean, I know this aria is kind of an over the top thing in the beginning, you know. I don't know.
I mean, before I had basically nothing there.
Yeah. Hear it one more time. Yeah, it's that stretch. I know, that sounds like the whole aria. So this is after the...
No, I know what you're talking about.
Less aggressive and more playful and joyful that time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just thinking about why it's there helped a lot.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, that's my sense.
Because when I was doing it with my old ornamentation, where it was just terrace dynamics and staccati,
right.
I was treating it like laughter there, so it should still be laughter when I do this new ornamentation, because that's what it sounds like.
Well, right, yeah. I mean, and that is the affect that you're, you know, it's overjoying, bubbly, happy, happy, happy. Yeah.
I was thinking about it too hard before.
Yeah, but I really liked that. That didn't seem as aggressive when you did the bop, 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 you know.
Yeah, it was a lot lighter.
And did you do the figure three times? I'm trying to remember.
I do da-da-da, 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 something like that.
Okay, yeah, you don't want to go any more than three or four, because, you know, there's that rule.
Mm-hmm.
You don't want to do
that. Well, I changed it up after two.
Yeah. Cool, cool, cool. Yeah, could we start at the... this is the... where Handel has written the... Otherwise, it gets a little either thin or a little kind of edgy pressed, and you don't want that.
Yeah.
And you're not going to be able to move as facilely.
Quickly.
There you go. I had something profound. What was it that I was going to say? The very end cadence, that's a long time to sit there and do stuff. I'm wondering if it's too long.
Mm.
Do you know what I mean? Because, I mean, we've been, like, this very rhythmically driven aria, and suddenly we, like, really come to a stop.
Every single person that I looked at, that I put a cadenza there.
Uh-huh.
Every single person.
Okay.
I looked at like four or five different people.
Yeah, I listened to Joan a couple of times last night, and there was a recording of her from, like, I don't know, 63, 64 on a television thing. And she, rather than doing a big thing, she basically, you know, and then she basically kind of sang the whole last little bit just up there high. And she didn't do a lot of retard or anything like that. Here, one more time, if you got one more time through there. So this is on the big sustain.
Slow down. I didn't last night either. I didn't slow down a ton. I didn't like put a huge fermata on it, but I just kind of stretched that one beat.
Yeah.
Da 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 da.
Yeah.
Kristen had also given me the coaching to make sure that I get us back to the tempo for the last note.
Dee, da, da, bum, be, da, ba, ba. Right.
So it sounds more conclusive.
Yeah.
So
yeah, that last time through, I kind of felt like, rather than the train stopping, that the train was still running and you were waving out the window a bit more.
Yeah. So some of the people who I watched put like a huge long cadenza there, and I was like, that's too much after all of the fireworks I just did.
Yes.
So I basically just added a little arpeggio.
Yeah.
Because I didn't want it to be too much.
Right.
But if I keep moving it through, it'll feel more like that. Even though that one beat is still stretched.
Yeah.
Basically it becomes two beats.
Yeah. And it's that idea that it's not a complete stop of everything, but it's making us anticipate that final resolution instead of, okay,
this is a vehicle
scene
for me.
yeah, exactly. I mean, the whole aria is a vehicle.
Yeah.
But I really like what you've done, and I think the thing that was troubling me earlier, we kind of dealt with the just not driving. So I think the take-homes from today have been about flow.
Yeah.
You know, flow when you're articulating and when you're doing those staccati.
Yeah.
I mean.
Yeah, because I've noticed something in my recent recordings, which is that if I have a run or a sustained high note, sometimes it pushes sharp, and it's because I'm squeezing instead of flowing.
Yeah.
So.
Want to do a little warm down here?
Yeah, that'd probably be helpful. I'm feeling a little bit in the stratosphere right now.
Sure. Yeah, we're about here. Let's start higher. So, just how about
A-O-E.
One more time. Be mindful of your tongue.
Did it pull back again?
A little bit, yeah. Sound is really different. A-U.
felt smoother. My speaking range.
Yeah. And you know, I think, you know, as high as you sing, you need to be sure you do a little warm down.
Yeah, I usually do at home.
You know, and
even if it's just a...
Yeah, exactly. You know, lip bubbles, raspberries, a little, you know, chanting, speaking, those kind of things. Just
yeah.
to bring your voice back down, because it's easy to kind of get stuck up there, you know?
Yeah.
And then that affects the freedom and quality of your speaking voice for hours to come. But I think for a lot of reasons, I mean, what do we see in sports? You know, like if I go run 10 miles,
mm-hmm.
it's good for me to walk a lap or two after I'm done.
Yeah. To remind your body what normal movement is like.
Yeah, exactly. And, you know, to allow that, you know, bringing your heart rate back down,
mm-hmm.
bringing your respiration rate back down, and allowing your body to kind of get out some of the metabolite, you know, stuff that's in your muscles from having been very, very active. And so the same is true, you know, the micro muscles in there. And doing a little neck massage and some
mm-hmm.
stretching and snorts and tongue stretches and so on afterwards. Then you're not carrying that stuff around that might have built up from athletic singing. And then the next day when you go to sing,
mm-hmm.
chances are better that you're going to start free or two.
Yeah.
Whee. Yeah, it's especially true with the really high soprano and really high tenor voices,
mm-hmm.
it seems like.
Yeah. So high.
Yeah.
Oh, man. So, my favorite recording that I found a new coloratura role model
uh-huh.
in Amanda Forsyth.
Oh, yeah.
She's amazing.
Yep.
Her ornamentation of this, I wanted to steal the whole thing.